I'm Andi Luna. I'm with Lackland Reporter under Lunatics Reviews. I do movies, music, and books. And today I'm talking with Rose Chase Smith, author of Nothing Like Me. This is a book about a woman's journey through her life. She talks about from the time she was young until now, the different journeys women go through. And what's amazing about this book is that we are all going through this journey. I've been able to talk with her for a few times before this interview, and it's been absolutely amazing. So I hope you enjoy the interview. And Rose, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me, Andi. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Okay, so tell us a little bit how you got started.
How did I get started? Well, I've always written. I've always journaled and things of that nature, probably since I was 13, just like writing stuff down. Never had really thought about writing a book. I've written poems and stuff like that before, but just wrote them for my own interest, lashing out or whatever. But actually, about a year ago, a little over a year ago, I was awakened, really, by just a voice that said, write. Now, it was just write, and that's it. I woke up and, you know, checked with my husband to see if he was talking in his sleep, and he wasn't. And it was just so loud and so firm of a voice that it moved me to, you know, start reaching for a journal, and I got up out of bed, and it was at 2:45 in the morning, and went to my desk and started writing. And I always start with the date, okay? And so there's a calendar next to my desk, and I looked there, and it was January 9th. So I wrote down January 9th, 2011, and I thought, okay, let me see the last time I wrote in this journal. Now, this journal I picked up in the dark, so I flipped to the front of the journal, and I had written in there since January 9th of 2010, exactly a year ago, hadn't written anything since. And I started the entry out by saying, I'm sure it's no coincidence that I picked up the same journal, you know, that I hadn't written in for a year before to start this. And I really just started writing a journal entry. I talked about a conversation I'd had with a niece of mine before, because it was very enlightening, and we had shared some stuff together, and so I was just writing that. And then my children and my husband got up that morning ready to go to church, and I was still sitting in the same spot writing. And I continued writing in there, and then I realized that I was supposed to be putting that somewhere else, and the rest is in your hand right now.
Well, I read it in one night, as I told you. What I like about this book is there is something for everyone in this book, whether you're married, whether you're single, whether you're 18, or whether you're 50. You're able to share so much, and even in some of these spots that you have not even reached yet yourself, but yet you're able to say, here's what's going to happen, and if you have this attitude, you're going to get there just fine. Mm-hmm. And I know that you started an organization. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a mentorship for women. One of my favorite chapters is about women becoming more of a sister instead of competitive and tearing each other down. Mm-hmm. As we talked about in the book, as women, we already do that enough ourselves. Absolutely. We already take care of everyone else. We should be supporting each other and not tearing each other down.
Absolutely.
So you wrote also a chapter, with success comes the criticism and comes the backbiting. How are you dealing with that so far? Have you had any just face-to-face, or has it just been kind of subtle?
I haven't had any face-to-face. It has been some subtle stuff here and there, but number one, my relationship with God, my faith is so strong that that's where I just kind of channel that stuff to. But I'm human, so, you know, stay tuned. You never know what you might hear later down the road. But that is one of my passions. That's really what fueled me to start Roses, which is the name of the organization that I founded a couple years ago, which Roses stands for Reaching Out, Supporting Every Sister. And it was to create a sisterhood, because there are so many of us that go through life never being the person that we should be. You know, we allow criticisms, we allow peer pressure, we allow someone who doesn't have a dream to crush our dream. And then sometimes we never feel worthy. You know, whether you have a great idea, you know, it's something you like, but you never really project yourself in that direction to start doing what you really are destined to do. So I expect it. And matter of fact, I always tell women that if you're not getting any type of criticism, or you're not getting, the younger people say haters, if you're not getting any of that, that you might want to take a look at what you're doing and do a self-examination and say, hey, maybe I need to be doing some other things, because that's just part of being a human. People just do that. And so my quest is just has just been to just bring people closer together. Coming from a very small town, Luling, Texas, a little small country town, community was huge. You weren't just raised by your parents, you were raised by your grandparents and teachers and Sunday school teachers and things of that nature. And so when you grew up, it's kind of like you grew up with a whole crowd cheering you on. And that, I think the world's really gotten away from that.
I agree. Yeah. I agree. And I think right now in the times that we're in, with the economy, with elections coming up, just all the things that we've let get in the way, I really think the world is ready to come back to the community sense. Doesn't necessarily have to be family as far as blood. Doesn't have to be your next door neighbor. But I really think that it's time for us to start reaching out and trying to kind of push that movement forward in the community and bring, whether we live in Austin, if you live in downtown Austin, there's still no reason why we cannot be more of a community.
I agree.
Especially the women. Mm-hmm. You know, all this time the world has been ran by men, and I think it's time for women to start stepping out into the spotlight and start saying, hey, you know, we're here. It's not that we don't want to run, you know, we just want to be more assertive and say, we have a way to help you, and we have a way to do this. And you also talk about married people in here, and you also write to men in here, which I think it's very important that men read this book as well.
Absolutely.
You said your son read it as well.
Yeah.
I think men would have a great time reading it because they would get a better understanding of women from the inside out.
Absolutely. And I'll tell you this, I've gotten some of my best reviews so far from men.
Great.
Yeah, I had one gentleman that I admire a lot that actually sent in a review, said that he read it, said that he was totally enlightened by the book, said that he had a newfound respect for his wife, for the role that she has. He said it encouraged him to step outside his comfort zone because there's something that he had been wanting to do for years and hadn't done it because an older sibling had done it and was really good at it. And so now he has started taking on a little venture. So, I mean, it is something for everyone. I mean, bottom line is that women are responsible for all of the population. We're responsible for,
exactly.
We got this thing started. And so, you know, women are very instrumental in the upbringing of children and so many things. And our voice needs to be heard. And so I just encourage everyone, you know, whether a woman or a man, to pick this up because it is something. It'll help you with your mother, your relationship with your mother, your daughters, your wife, anyone. It's like I said, every one of us has a woman that's been instrumental in our life, and it will help you understand her journey. And I think that's why we have so much confusion, is because people aren't willing to take the time to understand. You're here because of your journey. I'm here because of my journey. But it's no reason why we can't start now and finish our journeys together.
Yes.
You know, and I think that's why you get a lot of competition and people, you know, pushing to fit in and things
right.
like that.
Right, yeah. I think that's a good message. So what are you, with your organization that you have, the Roses, and the book, how are you incorporating the two together?
Well, in 2012, we've got several women's workshops that are scheduled. And my whole thing was I wanted to write something in alignment with the purpose of Roses. So I wanted the women that attended the workshops to have a takeaway. Something that even though they've left the workshop and, you know, they felt good while they're there, but they're gone, they have something to fall back on. And then not only that, to pass it on to other women and just kind of, you know, keep the movement going, because life is so busy. You know, we're so big. Women, I know I get bogged down a lot with my children's stuff, my husband's stuff, our church stuff. You know, the Roses stuff, that I sometimes get lost.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden I'm upset and I'm frustrated and it seems like nothing is going right. Well, you know, I need to pick a couple things and do those good instead of doing a whole bunch of things wrong, you know, and that's usually what we end up doing, and then we're not happy. So I'm hoping that this book will provide an avenue for women to, because what has happened is they started talking about it. You know, women that would never have talked before have read the book and now they're talking. And so that's a start. That's a start in the right direction. So, Roses has started off in Austin. We started to venture out to some of the smaller cities, and what we're wanting to do now is just go statewide. So we're wanting to do, you know, Texas-based, and we've created a website for it and different things. So my plan is to just kind of integrate and make those workshops go throughout the state of Texas, just touching women, you know, as we go. So I'm just trying to make my little corner of the world better.
Well, that is great. So what is the website? What's the address?
The website is www.thetexasroses.com.
I like that. I like that. So let me ask you one more thing.
Okay.
When you thought about writing this book, did you ever come to the crossroads, like, is anybody going to publish it? Were you ever worried about that part of it? Because that's scary for a woman to do, or for anyone to do. You're putting your whole soul out there. And did you ever, and how did you find a publisher?
Actually, we did self-publishing in the beginning.
Okay.
The book that you're holding, we did all of the groundwork. And when I say we, myself and then my son actually did the cover. He did the illustration for the book cover. My daughter did the graphic designs. My sister and my other daughter has been helping me with the admin work. So it's been a family type thing that we put together, and it never occurred to me that no one would purchase it. I guess the only thing is I wanted them to receive it in the right manner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes you can put something out there and people get turned off by it.
Sure.
Or they, you know, it depends on how they feel about me. You know, they might say, oh, well, some of them are reading it because they're nosy, which is a good thing, because when they get in there, then they actually get some stuff that can help them. Or, you know, some people are reading it just because we have a good relationship, but whatever the reason is, the message is getting out there. So I never really worried too much about what it was going to do. I'm just really pleased, and I'm blessed that it's been such a blessing so far. I'm really excited.
Well, what's your next step? What's in your future for 2012 for your organization and for you personally?
Well, for 2012, like I said, I'm just really focusing with Roses, getting it out there statewide, getting more women involved, just taking it one step at a time. You know, more of the workshops that I spoke about. Doing more of those. What I'm doing for 2012 is, since we are going to be doing these women workshops, I said if I'm going to be helping women become better, I want to start with my own family. So I'm doing a family women's workshop and retreat in February. So that will be the kickoff of the workshops, and then we'll go from there. And I'm kind of using them as guinea pigs to see what I'll need to tweak, you know, for the workshops going forward. But we've got some other things aligned. I'm just really excited about this because there's just so many different avenues I can go with the book. Just letting God lead me down the path I need to go. But bottom line is, I just want to be able to encourage, every woman that I speak with in some small way, any way that I can.
I agree. It's very inspirational. So just go ahead and tell, I know that your mom's mentioned quite a bit in the book. So just tell us a little bit about your mom. And I think that's one of your biggest inspirations.
It is. It is. And my mother, Jean Chase, my mother, she's a very strong lady, very strong lady. We haven't always agreed because I was her daughter. And growing up, I thought, God, she is so strict, you know, just strict. You know, I couldn't go or do the things that the other girls my age were doing. And I she knew why I shouldn't go. I just wanted to hang with my friends. And, my father passed when we were nine, and when I was nine, so she raised us alone. She was a single mother, which was instrumental for me later down the road when I became a single mother, because it told me I can do this, you know, her leadership. I mean, I can't say enough about her, because she introduced me to God and Jesus, my Lord and Savior, and that's been the biggest thing that anyone could have ever done for me, and I thank her for that. But she has really been very instrumental. She is. She taught us how to be a lady. That's important.
It is.
You know, even when we don't want to be.
Yeah.
So she's just, I can't say enough about her. Really, I can't. She's been the model. She's been the foundation. In the book, I said, this is for you. This is my dedication to you for what you've done for me.
That's great. Yeah. So how can our readers buy this book?
It is available on our website, again, www.thetexasroses.org. It's also available on Facebook under Nothing Like Me. You can actually purchase it from Facebook. And then it's available on Amazon.com, the Kindle version.
Okay.
So those three ways at this point you can get it. It will be in the bookstores after the 21st, which is my book signing, and so we're working to get it into the bookstores beginning of February.
I'm very excited about your book signing. I cannot wait to attend.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you're attending.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me. Absolutely. I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Well, Rose, thank you so much for sitting down with us today. It's my first review to do on camera, so
I'm honored.
We just joined this journey together. So all to my readers out there, I very much encourage you to get this book, whether you're married, single, whatever you're going through, there is a chapter in here for you. Rose, again, is part of this community, so wherever you live, go ahead and purchase this book. And thanks for joining us.